Hello, thanks for stopping by. In today's video, I'm going to use a brand that I've never used before, Sunny Studio. I've been wanting to use their stamps for a very long time, so I'm very happy to share these cards with you today. If you've been following me for a while, you already know that I love to mix and match different sets to create a card. It's definitely what appeals to me when I look at stamp sets. The fact that I can pick a stamp here and a stamp there to build my own little scene. So for this first card using Sunny Studio stamp sets, I have the castle and some stars from Enchanted, trees from Spring Scenes, and some flowers from Spring Showers. I cut all the images using my scan and cut machine, and like always, I used my alcohol markers to color everything. When the coloring was done, I moved on to the background, I cut a 5.5 by 4.25 stitch rectangle out of Bristol cardstock and used 3 shades of blue oxide inks to create a night sky. I first applied tumble glass on the bottom half of the paper. I didn't go all the way towards the bottom edge because I knew that there would be a grass border. Next, I applied peacock feathers from the top of the panel towards the tumble glass section, and I blended both colors as nicely as possible. And finally, I used a cheap sapphire at the very top of the paper to darken my night sky. Next, some texture, of course. I started by splattering water drops on the panel. I dried everything using my paper towel, and next I added drops of liquid stardust to create a million stars in the sky. Next, I smooshed my peacock feathers and chipped sapphire ink pads onto my glass surface. I added water and splattered drops on the paper to bring contrast. To ground the scene, I cut 2 grass borders. And I didn't want to use green inks, I wanted to keep this enchanted look, so I used cheap sapphire and black soot oxide inks to color those borders. And to coordinate with the sky, I also splattered drops on those borders by mixing black soot oxide ink with water. Once the small border was dry, I stamped my sentiment for my princess using clear embossing ink. I sprinkled white embossing powder on top of it, and I melted it using my heat tool. Now to the interactive part. I cut 2 Bristol panels, a long one for the pocket die and a short one for the moving piece die. I used a pencil to mark the window sections, and next I stamped the images. On the short panel, I placed the princess with the crown on her head. I closed the door of my Misty tool to grab the crown only. I removed the princess and stamped the crown. Next, I masked the crown, I stamped the princess, and I masked her. And then I stamped the frog on the long panel and masked her as well. I used the same inks as before to color the background on those 2 panels, and because of the masks, some of the lines were not connected, so I simply used my Memento pen to fix it. And next, I colored the princess and the frog using my alcohol markers again. When the coloring was done, I taped the dyes on the panels and sent them to my die-cut machine. On the pocket panel, I applied double-sided tape on the tabs, front and back. Next, I folded the panel in half and folded the tabs as well. I removed the backing paper of the inside of the tabs and I folded the tabs again to adhere them. I used my bone folder to make sure that everything was sticking well and I also used it to rub the flaps. I found that doing this helps the mechanism to work easily. And applying powder along the tabs and flaps helps a lot as well. So next I folded the pocket panel in half and put the moving piece inside through the slit and I put each flap into a small slit like so. I pulled on the tab to interlock everything, made sure that the moving piece was lined up between the tabs. I removed the backing paper and finally I closed the pocket. Next, I wanted the pocket to be on the right side, so I placed the frame die according to this, making sure to put the notch side at the top. I cut the frame and attached it on the pocket using double-sided tape on the four edges. For the card base, I used a dark blue cardstock and I first attached the pocket on the right side. I applied foam tape on the rest of the card base and attached the remaining piece of background on the left. Next, I applied double-sided tape directly on the panel right below the magic window and I attached the larger grass border. And then I stuck the small border at the bottom of my panel using foam tape again. And finally, it was time to stick all the images to create my scene using a combination of liquid glue, foam squares and glue dots. Once everything was attached, I added white highlights on the images like always, and I stuck the arrow handle at the top of the tab to be able to pull it. And I think that's it, all done. A super cute frog turning into a princess in a land where the trees are blue and the roof of the castle pink. I hope that you like this new magic picture changer card. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!